easy method to remember the example of purification methods. Here purification method also important for competitive exams. They will ask one question from purification methods. Here organic compounds contain impurities in the form of solid impurities and liquid impurities. Mostly organic compounds contain solid impurities and liquid impurities. If solid organic compounds is present, they are purified by which method? Which method? This is melting point method. Melting point. Solids are purified by melting point and liquids are purified by boiling point. Liquids are purified by boiling point. Okay. Solids are purified by two methods. One is sublimation method, another is crystallization method. In sublimation method, the solid is directly converted into gas during heating. And examples are important. Which substance are purified by sublimation? Iodine, solid SO2, mercury chloride, camphor, anthracene, naphthalene, benzoic acids are purified by sublimation. And coming to second method, crystallization. Crystallization means solid is converted into heated, they form liquid, they again cool, they form a crystals. This is a process. Means crystallization is based on different solubility ability. Means it is the crystallization is repeating number of times, that is known as fractional crystallization. This crystallization, fractional crystallization based on solubility of liquids, solubility of the substance. The crystallization and the fractional crystallization is based on solubility difference. Solubility of the substance difference. Solubility of the substance is difference. Okay. Here in crystallization or crystallization is repeated is known as fractional crystallization. Here we are taking the solids is heated, they form liquid. Their liquid is cool, again they form a crystals. Which compounds means sugar and salt is both are mixed. They are separated by adding of ethyl alcohol. These two solids is added in ethyl alcohol. In ethyl alcohol, sugar is completely soluble and salt is not soluble. On the basis of differentiation of solubility, we are purifying. And KClO3 and KCl. KClO3 is less soluble and KCl is more soluble. And ethers and chloroform. It is used in purification of ether in petroleum industry. And alcohol and water are separated by fractional distillation. And second method is liquid organic compounds. If the organic compounds contain impurity as a liquids, they are purified by on the base of boiling point. Solids are purified on the base of melting point. There is a two types, simple distillation, simple and sublimation and crystallization. But liquids are purified by on the base of boiling point. There is a four types. On the distillation, simple distillation, fractional distillation, vacuum distillation and steam distillation. What is the distillation means? Here, we are taking the organic compounds, and heated. What happened? These organic compounds evaporated. They produce a vapor. These vapors are sending into the another container, And we are sending the cold water. This hot vapors cool by sending of cold water. What happened? They condensed as form a pure liquids. Here, this liquid contain impure, means it is, this contain A plus B plus C. Three liquids are present. But more volatile liquid is evaporate and condensed as a pure A is formed here. This is known as distillation. Distillation means liquids heated, we collected the hot vapors and cool, they form a pure liquid. This is the distillation. This is the four methods. Simple distillation, it is applicable for one liquid is volatile, another liquid is non-volatile. And boiling point should be important. The boiling point difference between two liquids is greater than 40 degrees. This is very, very important. The boiling point of the two liquids is greater than 40 degrees, we go to purify by simple distillation. Which liquids? Benzene and aniline, chloroform and aniline, and ether and toluene are purified by simple distillation because their boiling point is more than 40 degrees difference. And fractional distillation means both liquids are volatile, both can operate, but boiling point difference is very less, less than 40 degrees. The two liquid boiling point difference is less than 40 degrees. We go to fractional distillation, example benzene, toluene and methyl alcohol and acetone, we can be purified by fractional distillation because both are volatile and less boiling point is the difference less than 40 degrees. And coming to vacuum distillation or reduced pressure distillation, here H2O2, formaldehyde, glycerin or glycerin or glycerol have high boiling point. They have 1000 degrees of boiling point. So we have to reduce its boiling point by sending off vacuum or reducing. Means we are decreasing the boiling point of the liquid then purified. Because in vacuum distillation, which type of liquids are purified? The liquids contain high boiling point. We are sending the vacuum or decreasing the pressure, what happened? The high boiling point of the liquid is break before reaching the boiling point. Means the boiling point of the liquid is decreased. So they are purified. Hydrogen peroxide, formaldehyde, glycerin and glycerol are purified by vacuum distillation. And fourth step is steam distillation. Here steam distillation is applicable for the liquids which are not soluble in water and they produce the steam, vapors in the presence of steam. Means this nitrobenzene aniline, ortho nitrophenol, bromobenzene, ortho hydroxybenzaldehyde and ortho hydroxyacetophenol. These are the liquid not soluble in water, but they produce the vapors in steam. So they are known as steam distillation. And third is we can use for purification of solid and liquids by solvent extraction or differentiation extraction. Means these organic compounds contain with the water. Aqueous organic compound means organic compound mixed with water. We are separating the water and organic compound by this method. Suppose I got the one mixture, that is a benzoic acid is mixed with water. I want to separate the benzoic acid from water. So I added one solvent, that is a benzene at the top. See, benzoic acid is not soluble with water, immiscible. Immiscible means not soluble, they form a layer. So if rotation of this vessel continuously, what happened? Benzoic acid is migrated and mixed with the benzene and water is coming at the bottom. So benzoic acid and water is separated. This is known as solvent extraction technique. And last one is latest technology is chromatography. Chromatography means separation and purification of the organic compounds on the base of color. Chromato means color. Graphy means writing. Chromatography is the latest technology. Nowadays we are using to purify the all organic compounds. So this is the latest technology. Chromato means color, graphy means writing. Chromatography. So chromatography. Chromatographs are two types. I am briefly writing. This is a adsorption chromatography. And partition chromatography. Okay, adsorption chromatography and partition. This chromatography was proposed by who proposed? Chromato means color, graphy means writing. It was proposed by Sweet. Who? Sweet. He purified the organic compounds on the base of color separation. Chromatographs are two types, adsorption chromatography and partition chromatography. It is a two types. That is Holmium chromatography and thin layer chromatography. Thin layer chromatography. Okay, here partition chromatography is only one, that is paper chromatography. Paper graphy. Okay, here in Coleman chromatography, Coleman means it contains big long glass tube. We are taking the different organic compounds A and B and C and D, they are purified on the base of adsorption capacity. Here we are taking the one glass plate and organic mixture. This is also based on, we are taking the one liquid. We are sending one liquid top to. This liquid is moving upward due to capillary action. This liquid coming down. This is a Coleman chromatography, long glass tube. It is a thin layer chromatography, means glass plate. Here in both adsorption chromatography, what is the stationary phase and mobile phase is important. Mobile phase and stationary phase. Okay. Here mobile means standard. Standard is mobile phases are solid. Here mobile phases are moving. Moving is liquid. Mobile phases are liquid or gases. Stationary phases are mostly we are fixed, na, that is solids. Okay. Here also mobile phase and stationary phase. Both are liquids. We have identified these different colors on the base of sending of ultraviolet rays. Here one point is eluent. Eluent is important. What is eluent? Eluent. Eluent means we are sending the liquid, na, this liquid. We are sending the liquid. That liquid is known as eluent. What is the eluent? Here the liquid. Eluent means the liquid passing on mixture of organic compounds. Okay, means we are sending on one liquid from the organic compound, that is a eluent. Means chromatography means separation of the and purification of the organic compounds on the base of color separation. Chromatographies are two types, adsorption chromatography and partition chromatography. Adsorption is two types, Coleman chromatography means glass plate, long glass, and thin layer means thin layer chromatography. Partition chromatography is a paper chromatography. In this, mobile phase is a solid or liquid or gas, stationary phase is a solid. In this, mobile phase and stationary phase is same, that is liquids. Okay.